We were very surprised. We were not expecting that, and we learned about it only on Friday at 10 o'clock. And the committee informed us that they would make the official announcement at 11 o'clock. So it was really gratifying, of course. We were very honored.
The two things about the Nobel Prize, isn't it? And on the one hand, it recognizes things that you've done in the past, but it also states that there are still things that need to be done to reach a world where there are no chemical weapons. What do you think this prize is going to do to bolster that effort?
Actually, I hope that this prize will give new momentum to our search for full universality of the convention. There are still six countries which are outside of the organization, which we expect them to join the convention as early as possible. And the decision makers, I'm sure, will take this into account. For many of them, there is no reason, in fact, to stay outside of the convention. Once we achieve the full universality, of course, we will be in a better place to eliminate all those existing chemical weapons stockpiles and prevent their reemergence.
How far are we away from that? Because we know we've made a lot of headway, but there are still some out there.
As to the remaining stockpiles, I think some years, but I can't say that many years. Probably 4 to 5 years would be enough to destroy the remaining stockpiles. And as to the new members, we don't know, of course, whether they possess chemical weapons or not. So once they will join, they will have to declare their possible possession of chemical weapons, and then we'll have to deal with them.
Mm. How big a deal is Syria joining the convention now and becoming a member state? Because Syria was known to have one of the largest stockpiles, even though they were kind of veiled about the whole thing.
Their initial disclosure on 14th of September was close to our estimates, and now they are being examined. Questions are being raised with the Syrian government. Their stockpiles are quite substantial, as you know, and we are working on possible methods of destruction. Most of the chemical substances are in large containers. They are not weaponized, so this may facilitate our job, in fact, to neutralize them and then to incinerate the toxic waste afterwards.
How much has been achieved so far?
Actually, in terms of destruction, very little so far. Some warheads and bombs, empty bombs, were destroyed in the presence of our inspectors. But also some production facilities and mixing and filling equipment were rendered unusable.
How is the Syrian government cooperating?
We have found them quite cooperative and transparent. They were able to answer most of the questions. There are a few questions that need to be answered, but they are working on this. But so far, we have been satisfied with their cooperation.